Hi, my name is Daniel and I'm from 3DHD Scan. Today we start scanning something easy, like a tree stem.
Here is our object of interest. I think very nice, and it will be also a very nice model at the end, I hope.
For the weather, I need to say best way it's if it's cloudy, overcast, so you don't have sharp shadows, because they will be baked into the model, and when you won't create your new lighting, it will be there. So it's very important to have an object without sharp shadows.
Before we start scan, we need to clean up place around object. It could save you many time in post-production later. And here it goes. Close. They protect you from all mess and dirty. You don't know who pees on all these things. So protect yourself. Place around the screen and now we can start scan.
So we need to see and start photo apparat. Next what I need is to set up AV. We can start LCD. Nice. And last thing I need change is this. So pictures will be very sharp at the end.
So now I have everything prepared for the start shooting pictures.
In first round I shot at the rest position.
And also CC in vertical position. So take now grip.
As I mentioned, everything is shot on the AV settings, and because I shot it from tripod. I set aperance to 22, but now I will try some details, and I need to change aperance a little bit down because I cannot stay so quiet so long. So let's go.
Hi guys, so next step will be creating model in the reality capture. Then we will this model optimize and bake textures. Then we optimize texture, and at end we will prepare scene for Sketchfab. So let's get started. I already downloaded images from camera to computer, and now we starting reality capture. Reality capture is very wonderful software where we can create very nice models. It is very easy to use. First of all, you go to workflow, images, and you select all images we capture. So you see there it's more than 100 images. Next, what you need is to go to alignment and click align images, which will align images in 3D and make point cloud, but very briefly point cloud. As you see, aligning images took roughly about 2 minutes, and now we have a position. You see a position. I can make bigger cameras, so software has computed all the position of the camera in the scene, and now we can choose what exactly volume will be computed much more better way. But this is only preview, so it give you something like overview. So next step, we go to reconstruction and we set can choose between automatically and manually region, which will be next computed in much better resolution. So let's see, good. I need everything to have inside this box, and I can adjust clicking of the handles. So now I'm happy, and maybe I can click in the center. So now I'm happy, and I can choose between few settings. Preview will be generated very easy and very quick, but the results it's not so good. So let's do the preview.
nice, but it's slow. Or we can select normal or high detail. I usually select normal detail and it will now start computing much more better result. And there is it. Now we see the full high resolution model just without textures. It's very nice. I think detail is brutal. And next step, what we need is add the texture. And I highly suggested to you, or recommended to you, try to simplify tool. And you know, my computer has only 12 gigabytes RAM, so I cannot make model bigger than 15 millions polygons. So I will try if my computer can do that. So yes, super. So at the end we have high poly model which has 15 million polygons, which is very nice. So now we have a calculated model with 15 million polygons exactly, and now we should start calculating texture. So I hit the texture and it will take also some time. It took 17 minutes to create texture and we are almost finished. I think beautiful model. So we will export it. So you need to reconstruction and click button. Now it's exported and I can simply go and push the 30,000 and again button simplify. So simplification took another 2 minutes. And we go and export low version of model. So we have high version with texture and low version without UVs and texture. And that's now from reality capture. Okay, next step will be optimizing model in 3D Max. So I'm starting Max and we will import low version of our model. So let me find the models. We have here models with 30,000 polygon. So I think very nice. First, what I'm doing is drawing some circle. And I'm moving it where I wanna have. And next step is going to the spline and add more spline. Yes, I wanna close. Next my step, maybe I will change the interpolation. 24, it's much more smooth.
And next step is to create some, extrude. And I'll use this object to cut everything out from the model which I wanna have on the end. So okay, next step is switch to computed objects. Yes, select the high, select the model, and we'll do boolean operation. Switching to subtract and choosing second operation, which is my first object which I draw. Then I go and select everything other, delete it. And now I will do some optimization in mesh, which is much more easy. So we look where we have some spikes. I don't really like spikes, so I do some changing edges. It will be better at the end. So let's say I'm happy with this model. And next step, what I need is to add UVs. So I'm using Unwrella, which is very wonderful tool. It costs some money, but it make my models very nice unwrapped, and it's only about to clicking on one button unwrap, and it works. So we will wait for the result. Okay, result looks like this. There is about 20 patches, so I think maybe we can start next and make some changes in the settings. We will see if it makes better UVs. So, as we see, we have a little bit better UV, I think, so I choose this. And I'm converting it to mesh. Now I will save as stamp 01. I have already prepared, so we have saved, and now I need to set up some things in render settings. So I enable SSA, and I'm choosing cut move room filter, which is very sharp. Next step, what I'm doing is adding projection modifier. So, and we go and set up also the part where we wanna put our texture. And now we are prepared to import high poly model, so I import it. Now we have imported high poly model, so I name it high, and I will set up new material. These things, I'm choosing the map. Okay, so I need to install this texture. Okay, and copy this texture to bump. I can instance it. This new material name hi, and I'll add it to the mesh, to the high mesh. Okay, and now I'm filling the projection settings. We need to pick high poly model and set up cage. Good enough, and now we go to render the texture. We have set up our output part, and now we go and set up padding to 4, projection mapping enabled options. I uncheck remiss check and invert up normal setting in tangent. So next step is adding diffuse and normal elements, and we'll set up it to 8K. Also the normal map will be set up to 8K, and normal map will have all put into normal map, which will use this map in bump and adding some details. So next step is check rendered files only, and I'll render. Calculation is done, so I can close this dialog and I will save a file for the new number. Next thing what I need is to optimize textures, so I will start Photoshop and load my textures. Okay, we have textures loaded, and I think nothing is missing. Okay, diffuse texture is almost perfect. I have wrote this little action which will extend color from the borders, and it will doing by using filter solidify from Frisbee. I'll maybe in future make video how to work with this. The same thing I'm using for the normal map. Now I'm saving one texture, second texture, and I'm making version for Sketchfab, so it will be 4K texture. Some filters on it, and I'll save it as JPEG. quality something for one map, only normally saving it to JPEG. Okay. We are done in Photoshop. Now I'm going back to Max and I'm choosing the high poly mesh. I will delete it, also the circle, and we have here our model, so I will add to them right textures. So we'll see this. Can look on it, and I think it's beautiful. Okay, last thing what I need is to save my file for the number 3 and export this model to proper folder, so to be stamped. Without everything, stamp. I'm exporting as a .bx file. Save, and I'm done for Max 2. I'm starting my Google Chrome page, and I will upload model from my computer. Okay, so I have set up my names and etc. So we will upload model and we go to 3D setting. So don't be scared. We need only change these little things. We have already beautiful model. So we will do some adjustments. The texture we have already set up. Go and I can publish it to see anyone use it. So this is how it looks like in detail, and it's very wonderful. Thank you for watching. I believe this is tutorial for beginner. Also, I apologize for my English. Maybe I will do it better in the future. So, if you like it, maybe subscribe, and we will do some more tutorials. We will scan some rocks, and rocks will be closed, so nothing will inhibit. Everything will be there. And also, I think in future we can do some tutorial about scanning of interiors, which is also very, very nice technique. Thank you for watching and have a nice day.